have any hair left at all.
Well, I could hardly be expected to do any better. Not with your hair so badly singed at Barnhurst.
Now, don't start. I don't want you to touch it, and I mean it.
I wouldn't touch it with a barge pole. Not with that ungrateful head beneath it.
Willie. Wilhelmina Beecham, you are without doubt the most obnoxious, annoying, and totally insufferable person I have ever met. And I don't want you to botch up my hair this time like you did last time.
Oh, I see. Well, I'll get out the rollers then.
Well, it doesn't have to be right now, does it?
Oh, yes, the sooner the better. We want you to look nice, don't we?
Now, I don't want to turn out like one of those frizzy-headed types. If I'm going to have a perm, I want a normal one.
But these are all I have.
Well, then use that thing you call a business brain and go out and scavenge some bigger ones.
Yes, I did see Jack O'Kennedy with some yesterday. Perhaps I could convince her.
Well, if anyone can convince people, Willie, you can. Who is it?
Detective Murray Cram, Miss Ferguson, Russell Street. Oh, sorry if I scared you.
It's all right. What can I do for you?
Just letting you know we've got watchers all around the house, so don't worry.
Yeah, I know. I saw the car outside.
Made a bit of a mess in here.
Left their mark in more ways than one.
Yes. Right, well, better get back.
Look, I'm sorry I can't offer you a cup of coffee. The power doesn't seem to be up to it at the moment.
Yes, I can see that. Listen, if you're feeling like a cup or a bite to eat, there's a place up the road. On me.
No. Thanks, anyway. Waiting for a phone call.
Right. Well, don't you worry. No one's going to get near this place without us knowing.
Come on, love. What are you looking so miserable about?
No. Who said there was anything wrong? It was pretty obvious.
I'm sorry, May. Now, look, they've said you can go to the funeral. There's nothing standing in the way of your parole. Now, what is it?
It's nothing.
It's not doing you or the baby any good storing it up inside like this.
I guess not. It's Mick Kirby. The one we figured out must be my baby's dad. He's coming here tomorrow. He's coming to lay claims on the baby, May. I know it. He wants custody because I'm in the can.
Well, how do you figure that out, love?
I don't know. I just feel it. I mean, why else would he travel all that way?
Well, hell, he's just found out he's going to be a father. And from what you tell me, he sounds like an all right guy. Look, you're tying yourself up in knots and all he probably wants to do is see how you're going.
Well, maybe he's got other ideas.
Oh, give him a chance, love. Oh, what's all that over there now?
Kick it. Go on. Get weird here with a Barnhurst one.
Now, the will fix it, Etty.
No, it won't. Look.
Etty! Oh, now, look, it's worse.
Yeah, well, I just thought, I've got to go and see now.
Did you fix it good and proper, did you, love?
No, it's the end of the program, that's all.
Yeah, I think you're right.
No, you got to come quick.
What's wrong?
Oh, I'm real worried about Jen. She hasn't stopped crying. She didn't eat her tea or anything.
Oh, haven't you found out what's wrong yet?
Nah. Okay.
No, leave it to Auntie May. You've got enough on your plate, love.
Thanks, Auntie May.
Everyone's in trouble tonight.
Are you all right, love? You know, you've got Daffy worried out of her brain. Now, what is it?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Oh, why not? Enjoy wallowing in self-pity, do you?
No, I don't. But can you blame me? After what's happened, what do you expect?
Show a bit of guts, just like your dad did.
What do you mean? You knew my father?
Well, sort of. Your mum too.
Oh, May. When? How?
It was a long time ago now. They weren't even married.
Oh, tell me about them. They died in a plane crash when I was 9.
Well, I didn't know them that well. You see, there was this big do at your grandma's house. I think it was your mum's 21st.
And you were invited?
No, not exactly invited. I'd popped along after it got started to check over the guests' rooms, pick up a few souvenirs, that sort of thing. A working trip, if you like.
Oh, May. Well, come on, how did you meet them?
Well, I didn't exactly meet them. You see, they'd snuck in to have some time to themselves.
And they caught you?
No, I ducked behind a curtain. But I reckon I could have done a fan dance in the middle of the room for all the notice they would have taken of me. They were so wrapped up in each other, they just talked and talked and talked. They kept me behind that bloody curtain for an hour. And was your grandmother mad? She'd look for them everywhere.
Oh, and she caught them. Poor things.
Oh, poor things, nothing. Your dad gave as good as she gave him. That's what I mean, guts. And that old lady was a real hellraiser in her younger days, believe me.
I do.
Well, your dad didn't take any nonsense, so with that sort of blood in the family, what's with all the weeps and sighs?
I don't know. It all seems too much to tackle.
What, this place?
Oh, no. I had a chance to prove I didn't kill Nana, and now it's gone all wrong.
Now, love, get out there and look for another way. Stand up and fight, just like your mum and dad did.
Meg. It happened all by itself, you know. Poof, like that, and it was gone.
What are you talking about?
The telly. The telly broke down. So, I've come here to get a book or something. And now what? You hear me? Might have a little talk, eh? Now, how's our Dennis getting on?
Oh, he's a little bit.
Don't you worry, love. Auntie Etty isn't the sort of person to let her loved ones down in their time of need.
Thank you, Etty, but there's not really much you can do.
Oh, there is too. I want to pay for the best help that you can get. So that young man is going to be fit and well and rearing to go in time for his wedding.
Thank you.
Oh, it's so exciting. I'm going to make sure I'm there too.
What?
I want you to ring my lawyer tomorrow so he can organise my escape from here.
You mean your release? You want to get out again?
Oh, I certainly do. And not to that retirement place either. Oh, I've got plans.
Oh, Etty.
Just get me my legal man.
Your lucky day, Ferguson. Arnie's agreed to your terms.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I bet you do. Good on you, love. See you around.
Been up to?
Well, she told me this morning she was medicating.
I think you mean meditating, love. You know, deep thoughts.
Huh?
Never mind, Daph.
She was talking about Myra all night. I reckon she's really upset because she can't go to the funeral.
Oh, I can understand that. Go on, I want to have a word with Nora.
Okay, I'll save your spot.
Okay.
Oh, you saved me one too. I'm going to see Officer.
Hey, that looks good.
Oh, ta.
Feeling all right?
She's fine. Been biting my head off all morning. But don't worry, I'll cheer her up.
Time do you and Mrs. Reynolds take off?
After breakfast.
Well, I'll let you get on with it then.
Thanks.
Coming, dear?
Yep, as soon as I finish my fag.
I'll see you at breakfast, Nora. If the company doesn't kill your appetite.
She a kingpin around here, or just think she is?
She's a mate of mine.
All right. Sorry, sweets. God! I'm bored stiff already with this place. Bet you're glad to be getting a day.